professor and head civil engineering department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So today I'm going to discuss on numerical, I'm going to take a numerical example on analysis and design of toe slab for a cantilever retaining wall. Learning outcomes. At the end of this session, learners will be able to analyze and design a toe slab of a cantilever retaining wall. Example. Design toe slab of a cantilever retaining wall to retain an earth embankment with a horizontal top 3.5 meter above the ground level, density of earth 18 kN per cubic meter, angle of internal friction 30 degree, SBC of soil 200 kN per meter square, take coefficient of friction between the soil and concrete 0.5, adopt M20 grade concrete and Fe415 steel. The preliminary dimensions of the retaining wall are as shown in figure 1. See, first of all, we have to assume the preliminary dimensions. These are assumed preliminary dimensions based on some thumb rules. So, top width is assumed as minimum 150 mm. Now, we have assumed 200 mm here, 0.2 meter. And here, this is taken as H by 12, where H is this 4.75 meter. So, we have to determine D minimum. D minimum is nothing but it is the minimum depth of foundation below ground level. So that is given by SBC divided by the density of soil into coefficient of active earth pressure square. So then we can determine what is the actual height of stem. Then further, what is the total height up to the base of the this particular retaining wall. So which is to be used for stability analysis of this particular structure. So without stability analysis, we cannot go for the design. So therefore, please, before viewing this particular video, see my own video on stability analysis of retaining cantilever retaining wall. Now, this is analysis of toe slab. The toe slab act as a cantilever of length L1. Here you can find this is length L1. This is a toe slab up to the face of temp slab, right? L1 as shown in figure number 2. Now, this is subjected to a pressure, varying pressure, P1 here, and at this phase it is P3, and at this here it is P2. Now, we are interested in only toe slab, therefore, we will see only P1 and P3. So, P3 is the pressure ordinate at the face of stem. Now, where will be the maximum bending moment in the toe slab? Can you guess? So please see, toe slab is a cantilever which is subjected to a trapezoidal pressure, P1 on this side and P3 over here. So the maximum bending moment in the toe slab will be at the face of the stem. So that will be at this location. This is the location where we find maximum bending moment. It's a cantilever of length L1. So therefore, at this particular face, we'll get the maximum bending moment. So for determining the maximum bending moment, following data is required, which are determined by considering 1 meter length of retaining wall. We consider usually 1 meter length of retaining wall. First, we calculate what is the eccentricity. So eccentricity of the loads which are coming down and the lateral pressure. So here we take moment about the end of toe and we find out what are the stabilizing moments and what are destabilizing moments or overturning moment. Overturning moment is only moment created by the soil pressure or horizontal pressure of soil, and stabilizing moment is the moment created by all weights. So weight of stem slab, then weight of base slab, then weight of soil on the earth. So which I have discussed in my previous video of stability analysis of retaining wall. So here B by 2, it is 2.5 meter is B. So therefore B by 2. So this is the sum of stabilizing moments and this is the destabilizing moment. The difference between these two divided by total weight downward load. So that will give us eccentricity. So P1 is the pressure at one end of the, at toe end of the retaining wall. It is sigma W divided by B into 1 plus 6E by B. So this should be in a bracket. So therefore, this is 163.33 sigma w divided by b is 2.5. 1 plus 6 into e is 0.335 divided by 2.5. So this works out to be 117.86 kilonewton per meter. So similarly, p2, it is sigma w divided by b into 1 minus 6 e by b. So that is again works out to be 12.8 kilonewton per meter. So all these forces are shown. P1 is here, P2 is here. Then next we have to determine P3. P3 is at the face of the stem. So it is P2 plus. So I will just show you in the figure. It is up to here, it is P2. Right? P2 plus this particular variation. So what is this remaining portion? Up to P2, it is P2 UDL, right? Then the remaining portion. Remaining portion we have to calculate by similar triangles. P2 plus P1 minus P2 divided by B into B into L1. So this is 12.8 plus 117.86 minus 12.8 divided by 2.5 into B is 2.5 minus 0.75 is your L1. So it works out to be 86.35 kilonewton per meter. So P4 is the triangular load. So here you will find in the figure, this is P4. So P4 is nothing but half L1 into this particular ordinate. So that is what we have written, half L1 into P1 minus P3. So that works out to be 11.81 kilonewton per meter. So bending moment M at the face of the stem is given by P3 into L1 square by 2 plus P4 into 2 third L1. So that is works out to be 30.19 kilonewton meter. So MeV is 1.5 times M. So this completes analysis of toe slab. Next is design of toe slab. So by equating MU to MU limit, the effective depth D of the toe slab required is determined and compared with D provided, which shall be equal or more than D required. Now this is your, this is our maximum moment, 45.285 kilonewton meter. To convert it into newton mm, multiplied by 10 to the power of 6. So 0.1338 FCK BD square, B is always 1 meter, 1000, FCK is 20. So we have determined D, it works out to be 128.09 mm, which is less than 350 mm, which is we have provided in preliminary dimension by taking 50 mm effective depth. Hence it is safe. Therefore it is under reinforced section and area of steel is determined by using G.1.1b equation of IS 456-2000. Now this is MU, this is 0.87 FY AST D into 1 minus AST FY upon FCK. Yeah, BDFCK that we have substituted, we have calculated AST, it is 366 mm square. So AST minimum is 0.12% because it's a slab, cantilever slab. So it is 0.12 by 100 into 1000 into 400, it is 480 mm square. So minimum steel can be placed on both sides or it can be placed on same side of the one, only one side of the base slab. Since AST required is less than AST minimum, provide AST minimum on in both directions, because AST required is less. It is 366 mm square. AST minimum is 480. So therefore, AST minimum I will provide in both directions at the bottom. Using 12 mm bars, the spacing of the bars is given by area of one bar divided by area of steel into 1000, that is 230 mm. Provide 12 mm bars at 300 mm center to center in both directions. The detailed arrangement of the reinforcement is as shown in figure 2. So here main steel 12 mm diameter 200 center to center, distribution steel 12 mm diameter 200 center to center, so that it will take care of everything. Now these are the references used for creation of this video. Thank you one and all.